Hi, I'm Al McRobbie at Saelig Company, and today I'm happy to introduce to you a new product from SYSCOMP, which is their SIG-101 signature analyzer product. So what we're doing is we're looking at what's in the box right now. So I'll open a box, and this is what you get. Okay, right here, this consists of the SYSCOMP front end right here, which will talk a little bit more about in a minute, and you get a power supply that goes with it, a little stand for the front end box, as I mentioned, and a USB cable. All right, so let's talk about the box for just a few minutes. The box comes in a nice aluminum blue anodized case, and it consists of two channel oscilloscope and a function generator output, and it's got a multi-pin connector on this end of it for various things which are diagrammed up here. There's digital outputs and digital inputs. There's 0 through 7 or 8 channels, and there's also a pulse width modulator output and an external trigger input as well as a ground. There's also a trigger output here. Then, of course, you have your power supply input and your USB connection. So this is a relatively low frequency unit. It's got a 200 kilohertz bandwidth. It's running at 2 megasamples per second and has a 12-bit A to D converter in it. One of the bits is used for the sine, so it's effective 11 bits. So this is pretty useful, I think, for doing a number of different things in entry-level school projects, or if you're somebody who's interested mainly in audio frequency things. One of the things we'll show on the screen is the vector network analyzer, which is an extremely handy tool to have. And we'll spend a little bit of time looking at the new signature analyzer feature on this in the software too. But there's two things I wanted to mention. One thing is that you need to get the software downloaded, and in the inside of the box right here, it does mention where to get the software from right here. And so it says download latest drivers at syscompdesign.com. And the other thing that I need to mention also is that it doesn't come with any other cables other than the USB cable. So you really need to provide your own oscilloscope probes and some sort of an output cable for the generator. And if you want to use the digital I/O on the back of the thing, we do also supply the ribbon cables with the connectors for this. So we have all of these accessories in stock. You just need to ask for them, and we can provide those for you. So of course, there's different grades of all these things, so it's sort of optional at extra cost. But that's the unit there, and so what I'd like to do now is just spend a few minutes looking at the general waveforms on the screen. Okay, so what we can do is move right into the scope display, which is the main display of the software right here. And it's an oscilloscope with 200 kilohertz bandwidth, like I mentioned. The waveform generator has a number of different waveforms you can see here: sine, square, triangle, sawtooth, noise. But it also has the ability to load in, save, and store a custom waveform. It can do sweeps, and it can do linear or logarithmic, and it can also put an offset into the waveform generator output as well. Down here on the digital I/O part right in here, you can see the 8 lines of input and output, but also there's a pulse output here with a duty cycle adjustment, and there's also a frequency control from this limit to that limit there. And so that pretty much comprises the general features of the oscilloscope and function generator portion of this unit. And there's also a number of other features that are available in the in the pull-down menus on the top of the scope display. Now, one thing else that's important that I want to mention is that when you get the unit from us, it's been rough calibrated at the factory, and so it will function and do a fairly reasonable job of displaying waveforms and numbers and things like that for you. But this unit has the ability for you to do some trimming in the calibration, so you can do some fine adjustment to it. And that is for both the oscilloscope inputs and for the generator output as well. So the adjustments comprise of both a high and low range peak-to-peak amplitude and offset controls for the inputs to the scope, and similarly for the generator. And this is important because when you get to the signature analyzer part, various fields in the signature analyzer are going to try to give you some actual real number values of the components you might be testing. If the unit has not been calibrated, then those numbers will be off. And so you may look at that and say, well, I'm trying this with a 100 nanofarad capacitor and it's nowhere near correct. Well, it means that you need to calibrate that feature. And so what you're going to need to do is, if you're at school, you certainly have access to an RLC bridge. And you're going to need to get some of those or some components and test them on that bridge. And then you can use those components to help set up your screens here. So that's just one of the things that I wanted to give you a heads up on before you get too far into it. So in the next scene, what we're going to try to do is show a couple of the features. We're going to show both the vector network analyzer here and also the signature analyzer functions. The oscilloscope part is very, very similar to their earlier product. This is a SIG-101. This is one that we've had around for years. But it's the scope is pretty much similar to that. So we'll explore these other features shortly.